Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Thursday, September 27th, 2012. Well, we've had a lot of economic numbers out this morning, but the stock index futures and commodities are still above fair value, so we're looking for a higher open Thursday morning at 9:30. This is going to be a very quick presentation this morning, and I apologize for that. I had some technical difficulties, lost about an hour and a half this morning. So it's coming up to 9:30, and this is not the time that I wanted to be publishing this. But here we go. S&P 500 was down yesterday. It's up about 7 points in the pre-market this morning, so it's going to erase most of yesterday's losses at the open, but we'll have to see if it can take out yesterday's high. Looking at market breadth, short-term market breadth, percentage of stocks trading below their 10-day moving average. We're coming back down to the bottom of the range here. We're also coming into the end of the month, so there's an end-of-month bullish bias. And then, of course, you've got the full moon this weekend. So this is the time and place where the market could start to turn around, and we'll just have to see how well that does. Now, earlier in the week, I mentioned that last week was an inside week for the S&P 500. And so what we were looking for is to see if it took out the previous week's highs or lows. And so we are down at the bottom of the range right now. Obviously, if we closed at 1433 last night and we're up 7 points, we're up to the 1440 level. So obviously, we're not going anywhere near the top of the range on Thursday morning. And we'll just have to wait and see how that works out. Now, looking at the NASDAQ, a little bit more weakness this week after some more strength the previous week. And so last week's bar actually traded above the previous week's bar, but didn't close there. So we've got resistance up at the top of that bar. And now this week, we've come all the way back down and even traded through the bottom of that bar, but have not closed there yet. And so a lot more weakness in the NASDAQ off the previous week's gains. And again, market breadth down at the bottom of the range, and we're coming into the full moon. We're coming into the end of the month. So this is the time and place where we could see the market go up for a couple of days. And looking at the TSX, still waiting for the VIX on the TSX to give us a buy signal there. So it looks like we're going to open higher this morning. Again, looking at the weekly bars, last week was an inside week for the TSX, so we're looking for a breakout of the previous week's range, and now we're starting to trade below it. Haven't closed below it yet, but we're certainly started to trade below it, and so we should expect the TSX to probably open up about 50 points higher this morning. That, of course, will not take out this week's high. And looking at market breadth for the TSX, again, we're down at the bottom of the range, so this is the time and place where we could mount a rally. Looking at commodity prices, no change for crude oil on Wednesday. It's up in the pre-market this morning, but certainly not enough to change a trend. Gasoline was up sharply yesterday for the futures contract. It was up for the ETF as well, so we're back on a buy signal. No change for heating oil. Natural gas continued to move higher on Wednesday. Looking at the metals, copper generated a sell signal as of Wednesday's close. Of course, that's not good for the mining sector. Gold generated a sell signal on Wednesday as well, so we need to close above 1764.55. For the GLD, we're still looking for a close below 169.62. For the silver's futures contract, we're back on a sell signal as of Wednesday's close. And for the SLV, we're looking for a close below 33.78 to give us a new sell signal. Last up this morning, quick look at some 60-minute charts. The VIX has made its way all the way up from 0 to it's now ranked as a 10. New early warning signal has gone off, and so we're going to play with that at the open. We are still projecting higher prices here for the VIX, but obviously we're going to see it pull back in the pre-market. Now, we've got a nice new open gap there that could potentially act as support. To really see the market start to move higher, we need the VIX back below 15. I don't think that's going to happen on Thursday. The first sign of weakness in the VIX is going to be an hourly close below 1561. And you see the bottom of the open gap there is just right around that level. So if we can take out the bottom of that gap, then you can get bullish on the stock market once again. Now, in the pre-market this morning, futures were up about 7 points. We need them up over 10 points in the S&P 500 to generate a new buy signal. So if you see it up above 1443.55 on an hourly basis, that'll give us a new buy signal. 12,259 for the TSX or 2805.54. Any of those levels would give you an intraday buy signal, and at that point you can certainly become bullish on the stock market once again and look for a move higher, but I don't think you're going to see that on Thursday. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. We're going to see a higher open Thursday morning, but I don't think it'll lead to a change in trend anytime soon. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.